Well, dear students, welcome to my class. This is the continuity of matter in our surroundings. Right now, in the last class, we have discussed the concept of that is can matter change its states? Can matter change its state? In that, we have to already discussed the effect of change of temperature. Change of temperature. By applying the temperature, we can change the states of matter. So in that we have to see the melting point. What is meant by melting point? So melting point is a temperature. It is a temperature at which solid is changed into liquid state. At its atmospheric pressure. This is what melting points. Solids has melting points. So next one is boiling point. So liquids has boiling points. So boiling points means it is also temperature at which liquid is changed into gaseous state at its atmospheric pressure, that we call as boiling point. Right now, this is all discussed in the previous classes. And one more is latent heat fusion. So before going to latent heat fusion, do you know what is meant by fusion? So fusion is a process conversion of solid into liquid states, that we call as fusions. Heat fusion means by applying the heat, we can change the solid state into liquid state. That is what heat fusion. So latent means hidden energy at the time of ice is changed into liquid. So temperature remains same. The contents of the beakers absorbs, or ice absorbs the heat energy. So temperature remains change, but ice sometimes will changes into liquid states. After the complete conversion of ice into liquids, then only temperature will rises. Partially conversion, temperature remains same. Okay, now that is what latent heat fusion. So latent heat fusion means this is the temperature required to convert the 1 kg of solid is change into liquid at atmospheric pressure at its melting point, that is what latent heat fusions. Latent means hidden. Okay, the next concept is sublimations. See, dear students, in your houses at the puja time, what we do, we have to have a worker comforts. Right now, from comforts we can do the puja. So what happens? So if you lightening the comfort, it will changes into gaseous states. That process we call as sublimations. That means solid is changed into gaseous state without changing in changing to without changing into liquid state. So changing into liquid state, that is what sublimation. Sublimation means the conversion of liquid into gaseous states without changing into liquid states. Example is burning of camphor. Burning of camphor, right? This is the sublimation. So one more important concept in this effect of change of temperature is that is conversion of degree Celsius to Kelvin. How to convert to Kelvin, degree Celsius? Conversion of degree Celsius to Kelvin. Degree Celsius to Kelvin. We have one formula. So degree Celsius plus 273. Degree Celsius plus 273. What is this 273? So generally the freezing point of water is 0 degree Celsius right now. This is a degree Celsius scale. And in Kelvin scale, the same temperature indicated as 273.15. Because of simpler form, we have round up that 273.15 as 273. So freezing point of water in degree Celsius is 0 degree Celsius, and freezing point of water in Kelvin is 273. So from this we can made a formula like this, because of conversion of degree Celsius to Kelvin, that is degree Celsius plus 273. If boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius, we can convert this temperature into Kelvin. How can you convert? So degree Celsius, that is degree 100 degree Celsius right now. So if you for this temperature you have to add the 273, we get how much? 373. This is the boiling point of water. So boiling point of water in Kelvin. This is the way to convert the degree Celsius to Kelvin. So how do you convert the Kelvin into degree Celsius? So now we have a 373 Kelvin. From this we have to convert degree Celsius. What is the way? So 373 minus 273, that is 100 degree Celsius. Okay, so Kelvin temperature minus 273, this is the formula to change into Kelvin to degree Celsius. Kelvin to degree Celsius, that is what we are discussed in our previous classes. This is very very important concept, right? So the next concept, that is effect of change of pressure. Shall we move? Okay. Effect of change of pressure. Effect of change of pressure. From temperature, we can apply the temperature to materials, it will change its states. Like from the pressure, we can change its states also. From pressure, we can change the different states of matter. For example, so I am taking a beaker. For this beaker, I am going to fix the piston. Inside the beaker, we have a gas particles. These particles has more amount of kinetic energy. Do you say what is meant by kinetic energy? Moving energy. Because of we have here more spaces, these moves randomly. Atoms cannot have a rest. They are always moving randomly, gaseous particles, because of this having a spaces in between the particles. That's why these gas particles has a high kinetic energy. So when we apply the pressure, when we push down the piston, this is what? Piston. when we push the piston inside, okay na, or downwards, this will moves to like this, move like this. Here the gas particles come closer somewhat, okay na. When we they are come closer, the space between the particles minimum, right? So the movement of particles, the kinetic energy somewhat less when compared to this beaker. Why? Because of I am going to give the pressure. So I am giving some more heat, some more pressure. Okay. In this, particles are very closely arranged. Very closely arranged. This is the process conversion of leaks. Is a liquid changes into gaseous states. After applying the high pressure in this gas particles are attract each other, the space between the particles very very minimum. That's why these gas particles change into liquid state. So what we use in our house, LPG, right? This LPG is a liquefied petroleum gas worked like this process, okay na? This from the gases we can take out the liquids. How? By applying the pressure, right? This is what effect of change of pressure, okay na? So by pressure and temperature we can change the different states of matter. So conversion of solid into liquid, what we call solid into liquid fusion, and liquid into gaseous states evaporation, and gases into liquid liquefaction, and liquids into solids we call as solidifications. This is all what we study in our matter, in our surroundings. This is a very very important concept. In the next class we will discuss about the evaporations. So what is meant by evaporations? Shall we talk about evaporation now? Evaporations means conversion of liquid state into gaseous states. Where we observe the evaporations from the lakes or from the sea, if you put the water outside of the from the sunlight, outside it to the sunlight, they will evaporate, right? It is what evaporations. Tomorrow we will discuss about the evaporation, right? Okay, thank you.